Hi there, and welcome to my Let's Play of Portal 2. Before we begin, if you haven't seen my playthrough of Portal 1 or played the game yourself, I'd recommend that you do. It's only 2 hours long and well worth the time in my opinion. I'll have the links to that playlist in the description. That being said, I've already taken care of the settings, so single player, new game, let's begin.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for 50 days. In compliance with state and federal regulations, all testing candidates in the Aperture Science Extended Relaxation Center must be revived periodically for a mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look up at the ceiling. Good. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, look down at the floor. Good. This completes the gymnastic portion of your mandatory physical and mental wellness exercise.
Gymnastics.
There is a framed painting on the wall. Please go stand in front of it. This is art. You will hear a buzzer. When you hear the buzzer, stare at the art.
This looks exactly like a Bob Ross painting.
You should now feel mentally reinvigorated. If you suspect staring at art has not provided the required intellectual sustenance, reflect briefly on this classical music. Good. Now please return to your bed.
Oh boy. Okay. Sleep.
Good morning. You have been in suspension for 9999999.
This courtesy call is to inform you.
Hello?
Anyone in there?
Hello?
Vacate the enrichment center immediately.
Hello.
Are you gonna open the door? Anytime? Oh, God. You look good. Looking good, actually. Are you okay? Are you. Don't answer that. I'm absolutely sure you're fine. There's plenty of time for you to recover. Just take it.
Please prepare for emergency evacuation.
Stay calm. Stay calm. Prepare. It's all I'm saying. Prepare. It's all fine. All right. Don't move. I'm gonna get us out of here. Oh, you might want to hang on to something. Word of advice. Up to you.
Hang on to what? Okay.
You all right down there? Can you hear me? Hello?
Most test subjects do experience some cognitive deterioration after a few months in suspension. Now, you've been under for quite a lot longer, and it's not out of the question that you might have a very minor case of serious brain damage. But don't be alarmed, all right? Although if you do feel alarmed, try to hold on to that feeling, because that is the proper reaction to being told that you've got brain damage. Do you understand what I'm saying at all? Does any of this make any sense? Just tell me, just say yes.
Space to speak.
Okay, what you're doing there is jumping. You just jumped. But never mind, say apple.
Apple. Apple. Apple.
Okay, you know what? That's close enough. Just hold tight.
All reactor core safeguards are now non-functional. Please prepare for reactor core meltdown.
Well, that's not good.
Okay, look, I wasn't going to mention this to you, but I'm in pretty hot water here. How are you doing down there? You still holding on? The reserve power ran out, so of course the whole relaxation center stops waking up the bloody test subjects. Hold on, this is a bit tricky. And of course, nobody tells me anything. No, why should you tell me anything? Why should I be kept informed, you know, about the life functions of the 10,000 bloody test subjects I'm supposed to be in charge of? Why? It's close. Can you see? Am I going to make it through? Have I got enough space? Just got to get through here. Okay, I just got to concentrate. And whose fault do you think it's going to be when the management comes down here and finds 10,000 flipping vegetables? Alright, see, now I hit that one. Okay, listen, we should get our story straight, alright? If anyone asks, and no one's going to ask, don't worry, but if anyone asks, tell them as far as you know, the last time you checked, everyone looked pretty much alive. Alright? Not dead. Okay. Almost there. On the other side of that wall is one of the old testing tracks. There's a piece of equipment in there that we're going to need to get out of here. I think this is a docking station. Get ready. Good news. That is not a docking station. So there's one mystery solved. I'm going to attempt a manual override on this wall. Could get a bit technical. Hold on. Almost there. Remember, you're looking for a gun that makes holes. Not bullet holes. But don't worry, you'll figure it out. Seriously, do hold on this time. There we go. Now, I'll be honest, you are probably in no fit state to run this particular type of cognitive gauntlet. But at least you're a good jumper. So you got that. You got the jumping on your side. Just do your best, and I'll meet you up ahead.
Apple.
All right. Off you go.
Okay. See you.
Go on. Just march on through that hole. Yeah, it's all right. Go ahead. Good luck!
Hello, and again, welcome to the Aperture Science Enrichment Center. We are currently experiencing technical difficulties due to circumstances of potentially apocalyptic significance beyond our control. However, thanks to emergency testing protocols, testing can continue. These pre-recorded messages will provide instructional and motivational support so that science can still be done, even in the event of environmental, social, economic, or structural collapse. The portal will open, and emergency testing will begin in 3, 2, 1.
This is exactly the spot where Portal 1 began. Nice. I really like post-apocalyptic, overgrown environments. So nice. Especially since I was just here. Everything's broken down.
Cube and button-based testing remains an important tool for science, even in a dire emergency. If cube and button-based testing caused this emergency, don't worry. The odds of this happening twice are very slim.
Put the cube on the button. Okay.
Please note the incandescent particle field across the exit. This Aperture Science Material Emancipation Grill will vaporize any unauthorized equipment that passes through it.
Well, the elevator seems intact.
If you feel liquid running down your neck, relax. Lie on your back and apply immediate pressure to your temples. You are simply experiencing a rare reaction in which the material emancipation grill may have emancipated the ear tubes inside your head.
Just relax, it's fine. Man, everything's broken down. Oh, by the way, you might have seen a bit of a blur inside the elevator. That's because I'll be cutting out most of the loading screens. No reason you guys should have to sit through those. Number one. Okay. Yeah, need the cube. On the button. Is the way out?
Good. Because of the technical difficulties we are currently experiencing, your test environment is unsupervised before re-entering a relaxation vault at the conclusion of testing. Please take a moment to write down the results of your test. An Aperture Science Reintegration Associate will revive you for an interview when society has been rebuilt.
When I said the elevators looked intact, I might have spoken a little too soon. Alright, let's get in. See what happens.
If the Earth is currently governed by a manner of Animal King, Sentient Cloud, or other governing body that either refuses to or is incapable of listening to us.
Turret King. Animal King takeover. Where I got the gun in Portal 1. Not there anymore.
Hey! You made it!
I did.
There should be a portal device on that podium over there.
It's not there.
I can't see it though. Maybe it fell off. Do you want to go and have a quick look?
Okay.
Oh! Hello?
Ow.
Can you see the portal gun? Also, are you alive? That's important. Should have asked that first.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to work on the assumption that you're still alive, and I'm still waiting for you up ahead.
Apple.
I'll wait 1 hour, then I'll come back, and assuming I can locate your dead body, I'll bury you. Alright? Brilliant.
Go, oh, nice.
Team! See you in an hour, hopefully, if you're not dead.
Later, buddy. Oh, there's the portal gun. You should now feel mentally reinvigorated. That's a lie. You didn't give me no cake. Tried to burn me alive. And they really put a lot of effort into the world design. Portal 1 was all clean and nice. Okay. Let's keep going. Really old computers with CRT monitors. Man, that's old.
Some emergency testing may require prolonged interaction with lethal military androids. Rest assured that all lethal military androids have been taught to read and provided with one copy of the Laws of Robotics. To share.
A whole copy. This way?
Good. If you feel that a lethal military android has not respected your rights as detailed in the Laws of Robotics, please note it on your self-reporting form. A future Aperture Science Entitlement Associate will initiate the appropriate grievance filing paperwork.
What the hell?
This next test is very dangerous. To help you remain tranquil in the face of almost certain death, smooth jazz will be deployed in 3, 2, 1.
Oh. No smooth jazz. Oh well. Hit the cue. On the button. And on we go. Number 4. Hmm.
Great work. Because this message is pre-recorded, any observations related to your performance are speculation on our part. Please disregard any undeserved compliments.
Disregard compliments. Okay, jump. Unreason. A cat. Bunch of mathematical equation. A cat Q. Yeah, I like cats.
If the Enrichment Center is currently being bombarded with fireballs, meteorites, or other objects from space, please avoid unsheltered testing areas wherever a lack of shelter from space debris does not appear to be a deliberate part of the test.
Number 5. Oh, nice. Gonna have to jump. I love those kinds of puzzles. Where to? I need to hit these buttons. Which... how do I... get there? Okay, so I need a cube. How would I... what would I put on the button? It's not dropping? Oh. And maybe hit the button that's right next to you? Now up the stairs. What's that do? Okay. That drops another cube. Okay, I get it. So hit that, then block it with this one. Or launch it. Okay, too late. And... nice.
Well done. The Enrichment Center reminds you that although circumstances may appear bleak, you are not alone. All Aperture Science personality constructs will remain functional in apocalyptic, low-power environments of as few as 1.1 volts.
Well, there's a bird, at least. I'm not completely alone.
This next test applies the principles of momentum to movement through portals. If the laws of physics no longer apply in the future, God help you.
Yeah, that would be bad. Okay. So, we gotta jump. Get that cube. Okay. Here we go. Get the cube. Come on. Okay. Line it up. Jump. And on the button.
If you are a non-employee who has discovered this facility amid the ruins of civilization, welcome. And remember, testing is the future. And the future starts with you.
I don't know what's worse, the psychopathic droid who's really trying to kill you, or someone who is so bad at pretending to actually care. Okay, oh, that's a big jump. On this? What's over there? Can I make this jump? What would that even do? Anyway, I'll try it this way first. And jump. And where do I need to put this? On the button over there. How do I get there? Oh. Portal here. There we go. Really curious though. Let's just try it. Is there a way to... wonder. Nope. That was worth a look. It's over there.
Good work getting this far, future starter. That said, if you are simple-minded, old, or irradiated in such a way that the future should not start with you, please return to your primitive tribe and send back someone better qualified for testing. To ensure that sufficient power remains for core testing protocols, all safety devices have been disabled. The Enrichment Center respects your right to have questions or concerns about this policy.
You're gonna have concerns, we're just not gonna change anything.
Hey! Oi, oi! I'm up here!
Hello, where are you? Where is he?
Oh, brilliant! Oh. You did find a portal gun!
I did.
Do you know what? It just goes to show, people with brain damage are the real heroes in the end, aren't they, at the end of the day? Brave. Pop a portal on that wall behind me there, and I'll meet you on the other side of the room.
I don't have brain damage, goddammit.
Okay, listen, let me lay something on you here. It's pretty heavy. They told me never, never, ever to disengage myself from my management rail, or I would die. But we're out of options here, so get ready to catch me. All right, on the off chance that I'm not dead the moment I pop off this thing. On three. Ready?
Ready.
One. Two. Three! That's high. It's too high, isn't it, really, that? All right, going on three just gives you too much time to think about it. Let's go on one this time.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Ready.
One. Catch me! Ow!
Nope.
Ow.
Whoops.
I am not dead! I'm not dead! Plug me into that stick on the wall over there, yeah? And I'll show you something. You'll be impressed by this.
Yeah, I can't do it if you're watching.
Oh, sorry.
Seriously, I'm not joking. Could you just turn around for a second? All right, you can turn around now. Bam! Secret panel.
Right open.
While your back was turned. Pick me up.
And off we go.
Okay. I'm gonna make a cut here. I'll see you guys in the next one.